present.
That's how you take
it. That's the cardboard holster, huh? That's why he carries it over the right cheek.
Look, if you move your mouth, head, I'll blow your hair right off your shoulders.
This is Oakland, buddy. This ain't no Alameda or Hayward or San Leandro or nothing out here. You gotta learn to survive. Only the strong-minded and the fast people survive.
Oakland's crazy, man. There's a lot of murders, a lot of violence there. People be getting killed there over drugs. People the whole time are testing you to see how weak you are. And if you're weak, they're gonna, you know, put you in some way, beat your ass or get somebody else. They'll all jump on you, you know, and you constantly have to defend your honor.
Most of the fights happen because of, I guess, it's body of warfare. Everybody, you know, we claim our 60s, and we don't want no one coming through here that it's gonna cause trouble or it's gonna make us look bad for the police, you know. And then they come through here, and we ask them, you know, if they're cool, then, you know, why don't they just go ahead and kick back party with us? But they start coming up with this 41st Quince and all this stuff, you know, we ain't got no choice but to say, well, you know what, we're from the 60s, big bad 60s.
You know, I'm leaving them right here where my brother's laying.
I mean, look how long since Georgie got shot. June 27, it's almost a year. And they know where the man is. I give him license plates, address, name, everything. 10 witnesses, they seen him shot George. George identified the man, and he haven't been arrested. Why?
Carlos. 7:30, it's time to get out. Okay? Get out, Carlos, I ain't gonna call you again.
I was 28 when I came to Oakland, when I took the bus from Texas to Oakland, and I had 6 kids. You know, my husband wasn't making enough money, and we had a lot of bills to pay and a lot of kids. And so, because he came over here first and he find a job, and then he sent me money to come down here. Then I was really scared because, you know, I was just new there, and then everybody tells you, don't go outside because I hear that, you know, that people is really bad.
Think he'd get out?
I hope so. I'm hoping. I prayed last night.
He just was in there.
I know. He didn't do nothing, but that's the way it goes. You guys have to stay away from places like that.
Yeah, they just don't like our family.
Well, it's one thing. Another one is that you guys have to stay away from places where there's a lot of things happening.
Mm-hmm. This is all Oakland.
This is also your obligation, and I want it met. Okay, thanks for coming in. We'll see you in 3 months.
People, someone out there, as I get older, I mean, it's not that they're going to see me as a young gangster all the time. They're going to see me as a person wanting to work. And that's what I want to do.
Okay. had a trouble in Hamilton because he's always been the leader since he was little. It's not that he calls the boys to follow him, but everybody follows him. And they used to stay outside a lot, talking with the girls or cutting school, and then he'll do it, and the rest of them do it too. And fights, a lot of fights against the blacks or Mexicans. You know, if anybody goes and tell him something, you know, he was ready. Carlos hates the Filipinos since that Julian got killed. And it does worry me when Carlos said, oh, I'm gonna get him, I'm gonna get him.
When it's quiet in the 60s and we start thinking about Julian and Ernie and, you know, how we really wish they was around real bad, we go over there and with a six-pack, we go over there and pour a little beer into their graves, you know, let them know that we're there with them, when we never forget about them. Nah, I tell you, I wouldn't want my kid to go through what I went through, because that's a lot of hurt to go see your heart when, you know, you're a grown-up. When you're about 16, 17 years old and you got a real close buddy and all of a sudden he's gone forever. You know, that's a real bad feeling. Cause you think about that stays, you know, scarred in your mind for life.
You all gotta slow down, man. Gotta slow down. All of us. Slow down. Pushing our lives too fast.
There's no jobs at all. There's nothing the kids can do. They really can't help it. They can't help it. Because they go look for a job and maybe they'll tell them they're not old enough or they have a record. And because you know they do. And they won't give them the job. They don't trust them. They should trust them, but they don't. And that makes it rough on the kids. Because they say, well, God, I don't got no job. We poor. We don't got no money.
I mean, I've had a lot of jobs, you know. Making $2.50, $2.75, $3 an hour, but I mean, to me, it's not really worth even getting up. I mean, I got two little girls, man. You know, what's $2 or something like that? Ain't gonna help me. Like all the times that I go and like look for a job, and they ask me if I ever been in jail or arrested, I put no on the paper, you know, because if I put yeah, I've been arrested, they'll say, well, come back next month or something. Yeah, I've been arrested about, I'd say a good 60 times, 50 times, I don't know, something like that.
Like initiation, you ask my buddy here, it's just initiation we go through to see if we do get in a fight or something, we won't let each other one down. Yeah, we'll be ready to take the blows, you know?
You stand in line and you let all your buddies jump on you.
Why do you do that for?
So you can see how tough you are.